So I'm here finally getting to talk about my passion, which is fly fishing. If you guys don't know, I'm crazy about it. When I'm not in the office, I'm probably on a river somewhere. So I decided to go through my personal kit and bring out some stuff to show you for winter fishing. Start here with the Filson Guide Henley. This guy is really what you think of when you think of Filson. It is heavy duty, bulletproof sort of sweater. One of the things I really like about it is you have this water resistant fabric that goes all the way down the arms. So if you're fighting with bushes and getting in and out of the river and you're dealing with a lot of overhang, this will keep you protected. Retains a lot of warmth even when it's wet. Next, we have the lightweight jacket from Filson. And if the Henley is what you think of when you think of Filson, kind of old school design, the lightweight jacket is the opposite. It's super lightweight, 60 grams of PrimaLoft insulation. Filson says that it keeps 98% of its warmth even when it's wet. I'm not so sure about that, but what I do like about it is that it's extremely packable. You can fit it into small pockets, a small backpack if you carry one. It also is a great underlayer if you are in a rainy situation. So if you put your shell over top, this will keep you really warm and it doesn't take up a whole lot of room. So lastly, we have the Kinsho Crossover Cowl, and this is a brand new addition. This is their waterproof cowl. It's made with this wonderful waterproof exterior, and it's got a very soft fleece interior. It does have a nice welt on the inside between those two layers to really keep the moisture off of you. And I'll just demonstrate quickly. This goes around the neck and gets worn sort of like this. And what I like about this is that it's not a scarf. You don't have tails dangling down or trying to tuck those in and keep those secure. It's also not a balaclava, which is really hard to sort of adjust. You sort of get bungled up in the neck, it gets really warm. This thing was really great. You can adjust various settings with the buttons. It's keeps you warm, keeps all your sort of vitals warm. You take it off really easily and it'll stow in your wader pocket or it'll stow in your backpack very simply. This is what I like to wear when the fishing starts to get really cold. And there's a lot of rivers in the Northeast as well as in the West that you can fish all winter long. So if you're in one of those areas, think, you know, the Farmington River in Connecticut, you can fish year round, a few rivers out west, Yellowstone River. The weather changes happen really quickly. You want to be prepared. These items will get you down into the single digits, but they're certainly great for 30 degree weather, right up into sort of a beautiful winter day where you're looking at temperatures in the 40s. So these are my apparel picks for winter fishing. Next, we're gonna look at some accessories. First thing I love is the Gerber Line Driver. This guy's a lifesaver. You have nippers on your vest or you use a small, you know, pliers or something like that to cut your line. These guys will save you a lot of aggravation. They have this really wide nipper. It has a clip that fits right onto your belt or it can fit onto your vest, which makes it almost hands-free. You can sort of pop it and cut your line very easily. It also has an eye-clearing tool. You can crimp weights with this tool. And it also spins, so if you're tying on big streamers, it saves you a lot of time. I find this especially useful. When it gets cold, your hands get wet and your hands get really cold. So it's sometimes really hard. You're fumbling with the small items. This can come in really handy. Next, we have two models of sunglasses from Smith Optics. Recently tried both of these out and I have to say they're both great but for slightly different reasons. First of all, we have the new ChromaPop green mirror lens from Smith's. The advantage of the green mirror lens is that it cuts out a lot of the ambient green light that you're going to find on the river's edge. As we get into fall and those greens turn to yellows and to oranges, that mirror lens really helps bring a lot of that reflection away from your optics. Helps you see into the water a lot better. These are the mags. These guys have a really cool piece of technology. You can actually pull the lens right out very, very quickly. And I've done this on the river's edge a few times, haven't lost the lens yet. For low light conditions, early in the morning or in the evenings, you want to reach for the low light igniter lenses. They will give you that polarized lens. They will shade a little bit, but they'll ignite a lot of the stuff that's in the water so you'll be able to see fish easier. Once the sun comes out, you start to deal with glare. You get a lot more ambient light. You want to reach for the mirrored lens. And you can pop these right in very easily. The other lenses go, get stowed, and you're off to the races. So between these two frames, you have some distinct differences. First of all, the Guide's Choice, you notice, is a nice wraparound frame. It's got a lot of coverage on the sides. These are really great for high light conditions. That being said, I do like the ability to switch the lenses out. Being able to reach for these, change the lenses when the light conditions change is really, really a great tool. And I found myself wearing these a lot more than I was wearing the Guide's Choice on recent trips. Lastly, we have the 18-ounce Rambler from Yeti. And I gotta say, this has saved me more times than I care to admit. Put some hot coffee in here, maybe a hot toddy, some soup, whatever you like. This thing will keep your beverage warm, I should say, or cold. It does work for cooling as well, but wintertime, late fall fly fishing, you're really gonna want something warm on the river. Whatever beverage or food item you choose to put inside, it's up to you, but it will work very well. And with this this great top, you can clip it with a carabiner or put it on a lanyard, secure it to your gear really easily. So you can find the Gerber line driver on their site for about $40. The Guide's Choice frames with your choice of lens is $229. The mag frames come in at $249. Remember, they do come with the igniter lens free of charge, and then you could add your second set of lenses on top of that. And you can find the Yeti Rambler for $30. So last but not least, we gotta talk about some real fishing gear here. First thing I wanna mention is the new Orvis Pro boot. They collaborated with Michelin to do this boot. Apparently their treading and the rubber composite that they use for the tread of the boot is supposed to give you additional grip on wet stones. I haven't found that to be the case necessarily, but I have found that with the addition of studs, these boots are really excellent. One of the things that they've really tried to do is make the boot a lot lighter. It's noticeably lighter. I don't have the specs on that, but I can tell you from walking in these for a few days, you don't feel them as much as when your traditional wading boots get wet and heavy. Orvis has taken the wader and redesigned it from top to bottom. I mean, there's really not much to change when you think about a wader, but they've really tried to make it conducive to spending a day in your waders on the river. First of all, they've added a 5-layer Cordura to everything below the knees. And this, if you guys have fished before, you know that you're constantly getting small tears or rips in your waders and then having to patch them. These are really robust, and they also have a built-in knee pad. So if you're spending a lot of time in small streams, getting close to those fish, getting down low, the built-in knee pads are a great addition. Secondly, they have added elastic to both the shoulder straps and to the wading belt. So I like this especially for fall and for winter fishing when you're changing layers a lot and things are, you're putting on layers in the morning and taking them off. Your width and how those waders sit over your shoulders is gonna change dramatically. So with the addition of the elastic, really makes it a lot more conducive for layering. All sorts of great features that you would expect from a pair of waders, a kangaroo pocket in the front with micro suede to keep your hands warm, a front pocket. I will tell you that even though this is a weatherproof zipper, it's not waterproof. Orvis does sell an additional pouch for your cell phone if you wanted like a waterproof pouch, and it would attach to the front of the waders just through these two little clips here. Next, I wanna talk about the Clearwater. This is a 10-foot three-weight rod. If you guys have seen Orvis's lineup in the past, you know that the Clearwater has traditionally been at the bottom. So it's sort of their entry-level rod. I must say the 10-foot three-weight is designed specifically for tight line nymphing purposes. So you get a lot of sensitivity in the tip. The taper is really nice for that. And you've got a lot of backbone at the butt. You can see here, you've got a little fighting butt and there's a lot of nice backbone in that fourth section. I've fished with this almost all year and I can tell you for an entry level rod, it performs really, really well. As you're getting into the fall and then the winter, you really wanna drop those flies as close to, as you can to those fish. So something with a nice reach, the 10-foot reach, and a lot of sensitivity, you can do a lot of great stuff with that rod. Next, I wanna talk about the Ross Gunnison. If you guys know Ross, you know they've been built in the United States for a long time. They're really proud of that. The Gunnison has been a model that's been around for years. And what they did recently was they totally redesigned the Gunnison. They kind of peeled back the look, redesigned all the guts, and then put the look back onto it. So if you see this reel, it looks very similar to what you'd expect from the old Gunnison, but what it offers you is their brand new drag system. The drag is a 2-layer drag. It is unbelievably precise. I fish with this a lot, and if you're going after big fish, especially in the fall when you get those spawning brown trout, you're gonna want a drag system that you can adjust really quickly, and it's gonna give you a precise amount of drag. There's no click here, it's just a system of pressure, and those two plates inside really give you a lot of definition. So I really recommend this. I will say, it runs a little heavy. This is marketed as a 5-weight reel, and I found it a little bit heavy for my 5-weight rod, so it's best for a 6-weight rod. So the Ross Gunnison you can find on their website, you can probably find it at a lot of Ross dealers. That retails for $385. The Clearwater from Orvis, at least in the 10-foot three-weight configuration, is $198. The Pro Boots come in at $229, and the Pro Waders are $498. So this is some of the gear I like to use late fall and winter fishing. I'd love to hear from you. What did we leave out? What are we missing? What should we include? Put your comment below.